Doing great, bud.
Say, Fred, you always told me that this world is built for four. You're talking about families and your decision to have only two kids, and you were pretty sure of yourself that you'd made the right call. Maybe you did, but my life until this point had always been built around five, you know, mother, father, three kids. That's how my dad did it, and that's how I'm doing it now. This past week, though, I took my first vacation with just my kids, and it was a golden opportunity to test your theory to see if this world was indeed built in a way that would make four a better number than five. The testing ground was Lake George, New York, and I discovered that, yeah, you were right. I also discovered I don't care.
Oh, hey, look who's up. So yeah, one of the first things I noticed was that traveling with only four people made packing for a camping trip just so much easier. I mean, it's not just one fewer set of clothes, it's just getting all this crap into the car to begin with. You see, I drive this rolling sex machine known as a minivan, and here's the thing. With only four people, I'm able to flip this last row of seats down completely, giving me the rough equivalent of, well, enough space to fit a body. Score one for you, bud. And another thing I noticed was that vacation is so much cheaper with one fewer person. I mean, I saved about $20 at the water park, 20-something at the caverns, $8 at mini golf, and of course, so much money on each and every meal.
Where was I? Right, saving money. I mean, who doesn't like saving money? No. Meaning everyone likes saving money. Saving money is nice. And what'd you say, Fred? Yeah, score another for you, bud. So you have a very solid point. And in many ways, it does seem that this world is built for four. And I can understand the logic of planning a family that fits the contours of a number that's seemingly provided by the universe. I understand, but I don't care at all. Because families are not supposed to come in neat little packages. Families are loud and messy and difficult. Families make you laugh out loud in public places. They grow together through both tragedy and triumph. And if you try to plant a family in a perfectly square box, its roots will twist and embrace until they explode outward, looking for a way back to soil. See, it's not a parent's job to figure out what this world is built for, especially because this world, just like everything else, changes. Things happen.
Death and divorce happen. Illness and tragedy happen. They take your family from five to four, from four to three. And if you think the whole point of family is numbers, well, you won't know how to make the math work when those big changes do happen. It's not a parent's job to figure out what this world is built for. Parents take the world they find, in whatever form, and they try to make it work the best they can for their kids, knowing that imposing order on family is about as impossible as quantifying love. Well, it's a shame it had to end this way, Fred. I always thought of you as a friend.